Today we are discussing the next type of multiplexing that is called WDM. WDM stands for wave division multiplexing. Now as the name waves comes from the light wave. Means whenever we are going to combine or multiplex the light signals, then this is called the wave division multiplexing because light is a wave. So here we are talking about the lights and they will be multiplexed together into one. Now, multiplexing means many to one, so multiple lights are combined to one. We already know that the multiplexing is having two ways of division. One is the analog and second one is digital. Under the analog, we are having FDM and today we are discussing the WDM, wave division multiplexing. So first of all, we can say that wave division multiplexing is the analog technique. As we know that wave means the light. Light means the optical signal. So there we are going to combine the optical signals, or we can say that it is the technique for combining optical signals. Now we are taking the example of the first diagram by which we will understand the WDM. Let us suppose that there are three light waves, assuming that L1, L2 and L3. So these are the three lights. Now these lights are going and they are merged together. So wave division multiplexing. So this one is the multiplexer by which we are going to combine them. So these are combined and getting to one. So L1, L2, L3, these are the three lights and they are combined. That's why it is the L1 plus L2 plus L3. Now they are going from other side. Let us suppose that this was the source and this was the destination. Now from source to destination, the lights are moving because source multiplexer is there, destination demultiplexer is there. So there we are again going to divide back to the separate lights at the destination side, L1, L2 and L3. So this is the multiplexer MUX going to combine many to one, and this one is the DMUX that is going to again divide back to the three different lights. So this is how the wave division multiplexing work. So we can see that this is exactly same as the FDM, frequency division multiplexing. In the FDM, frequencies are merged together, but here the light signals are merged together. But in our FDM, there was the normal cables like twisted pair cable or coaxial cable, but here we use the fiber optic cable. So we can say that it is same as the FDM, but light signals traveled through fiber optic cable. So if I compare the FDM and WDM, FDM means frequency division multiplexing, wave division multiplexing is WDM. Now in the FDM, frequency is there. In WDM, waves are there. Wave means light waves. In FDM, frequencies of different devices are merged and sent through a single medium. In the WDM, different lights are merged together and sent to the single medium. Now, in FDM, the medium is used the wire, and that wire is just like your twisted pair cable or coaxial cable. But talking about your WDM, there we are using the optical fiber cable. Because the light is transmitted, that's why the fiber optic cable is applied. Now, there are not the normal multiplexer or demultiplexer. This task is done using the prism. So we can say that the combining means multiplexing and splitting means demultiplexing of light is done by prism. Now in this diagram, you can see that there are three lights which are coming, light 1, light 2 and light 3. So these different lights are coming, and this one is the multiplexer. And for the multiplexer, we are using the device that is the prism. Now, through this prism, these are combined together. So these all lights are combined here. And now you can see that this L1 plus L2 plus L3, these all are combined and sent to the other side. So the first side is the source side and other side is the destination side. And here also the demultiplexer is there at the destination side. And this demultiplexer is nothing but one more prism. So this prism is again dividing back the light to L1, L2 and L3. So the lights are combined and sent. Then again, these are divided. So that multiplexing means many to one, and demultiplexing one to many, that is done using the prism. And yes, there you can see that the light is transmitted through the fiber optic cable. If we are focusing on this diagram, then you can see that the width of the wire, that is very, very small. So these three are very, very small. That means if these light waves are coming through the optical fiber, now this one is very huge. Now this is the signal strength. So these three signals are very small and this one is very huge. So because it is the combination of L1 plus L2 plus L3. So these three lights are merged together. That's why the signal strength is high here. You can see the dark line here. So we can say that the narrow band of light from different sources are combined to the wide band of light. So narrow band of light, narrow band means this is very small band, small frequency of the light, so small waves of the light of different sources, because this L1, L2 and L3 are the different sources, they are combined. Now this is the wide band, means very huge. Obviously, when the three lights are merged together, that will become the huge. So the narrow band of the light are merged to the wide band of the light. So this is the wave division multiplexing, in which the waves, light waves, are combining and moving through a optical fiber cable.